Her name is Oluwatu. This is titled Love Connection on Metro FM. 17 after 11, and she is my woman crush this Wednesday. She is in studio. If you have any questions for her, you're more than welcome to call me. 089-110-3377. You're still listening to The Front Row. How does it feel to hear your song on radio?
It's amazing.
Is it good?
It's amazing.
Hold the mic closer to you so we can hear you, sweetheart.
Hello, hi.
Are you there? There you are.
It's amazing, man. I still can't believe it. Every day when I hear my song on radio, I'm like, really, is it me?
Is it you?
Is it finally me?
But do you remember the first day you heard Love Connection on Metro FM?
Yes, I do.
And? What was good?
I was sitting alone, funny enough. I was sitting alone because it was played on Sunday by Cynthia. I was sitting alone. And then it played from nowhere because no one told me it's going to play.
Yeah.
I was screaming alone in the house. I was like, really? Why was I not told that it's going to play today?
On the day.
So I was very excited. It's very overwhelming.
Well, it's lovely to have you. I don't know if you listen to the show, probably you know
yes,
how obsessed we are with you on the front row. So we're really glad that you are here.
Thank you. Let's start
a little bit about your journey. I mean, you were born in Queenstown,
yes,
in the Eastern Cape. You look very young, by the way. Can I ask you how old you are?
25.
But let's start with, I mean, your journey. You know, your first project, you worked with Kooli Chana,
yes,
you worked with the likes of Zola and HP. But how did you fall in love with music, and when did you decide that this is the path you want to take?
You know what, actually, when I at some point in my life, I decided, you know what, maybe music is just not for me. Let me just leave this, because it's overwhelming, and what you have to do to go in the industry also is just a lot of work. But then I decided, you know what, you have a talent, girl, just go out there, go do it. So I was in contact with a gentleman that believed in my dream so much, and was like, you know what, let me work with you, let's start something. At that time, obviously, I was like, oh, one of those, let me just do it.
Yeah.
So he really believed in me. We did about 10 tracks. This was 2 years back, mind you.
Wow.
Yeah, so I finished it last year.
So this brand new album, you had already done.
It's been there.
2 years ago. So why did you decide then to, I mean, musicians, I know, they create all this music, and then some of it sits, and then some of it is released. So why did you wait so long, to release all this music that you've made?
I didn't want to have one hit single in the album. I wanted all songs in the album to be like, yes, she knows what she's doing.
Mm.
She didn't just release for the sake of releasing. So I believe all these songs out here in this album, maybe 8 out of 10
wow,
are good tracks, I believe.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to cook it well.
Yeah.
So that when people have it, they're like, yeah, good work.
But where did you meet, you know, Kooli Chana? I remember, now that I see your face, I'm trying to think where I saw you. With 1D, right? Is it 1D?
One dial. Yeah.
There it is. I knew I'd seen this face before. So how did you get into the whole Motswako? I mean, you're from Queenstown in the Eastern Cape. Where did you meet HP and Kooli?
I've been here like 15 years, so I think I know my stuff when it comes to Johannesburg.
Yeah.
So with Kooli, how I met Kooli was through my friend's sister. They were friends.
Okay.
And then she was like, I know of this little girl. I was so young then when I she's like, I know this little girl. She can sing so well. Why don't you like work with her? Trust you me, I had to call Kooli Chana almost every week. Kooli, can you work? Can you, like, when can I see you? And then eventually he had a song that he was doing, or Bondilo was doing a song with Kooli, and they were like, they need a female vocalist on it. So he contacted me, and then we worked.
That's amazing. So for anybody that has never heard you or has never heard your sound, how would you place yourself, and how would you describe the kind of music that you make?
I was thinking about that yesterday. So let me tell you, it's like this. Let's say when you are at Mafikeng, you're cooking for your family, right? It's a Sunday morning, and you're cooking. It's that kind of music that will take you on a journey. Let's say I'm going on a road trip with friends. It takes you on an emotional journey. It makes you reflect on a lot of things.
Mm.
It's just really very fresh sound. It's a very fresh sound, I would say.
And the song I just played now, Love Connection, is the first single from your brand new album, Imbewu, right?
Imbewu Seed.
All right. Okay, so let's talk about Love Connection. Mm-hmm. The first time I heard it, I thought, wow, what a mature young woman. She's probably like 34, 35. And now, you're telling me now you're only 25.
Only
so 25. What is Love Connection about, and who were you writing about?
Love Connection is, I wouldn't say I was in love, But it's just you placing yourself in a position where you're able to put yourself in someone's shoe, let's say the person that's in love. I guess we all have been in love, and I'm able to what is it? I'm able to write about something even though I never went through it. But okay. if I'm able to put myself in someone's shoe and maybe get a feeling of how that person was feeling, mm-hmm. then I'm able to write about something. Right. I would make an example of Mama. It's about being abandoned by your mother. I've never been abandoned by my mother. But when you're listening to it, you would think that, no, maybe she didn't have a home. Maybe her mother made her look after kids. But it's not like that. It's just putting yourself in a position and being able to, I would say, feel for that person.
Yeah, so you're able to put yourself in situations that you haven't been in. All right. So your album is called Imbe. Why that particular title? Do you see yourself as a young seed that's about to sprout in the music industry?
Oh, yes, I am.
Yeah.
I'm about to get there.
Yeah. So what are your dreams? You know, what are some of the things you want to achieve? And where do you see yourself? And, you know, what do you want to see happen for you and your music career?
Okay, as a young girl from the Eastern Cape, and it's a small town, you know, I would really like to be that one girl who inspires a lot of little girls out there who do not dream big, or who do not think they have it to make it out there. So I just really wish that I will be that one person that will inspire a lot of girls. Edgy, you. Mm. I would inspire a lot of girls to just make it out there. Because from my town, if looking back from my town, little girls now are getting pregnant because I guess they don't know what to do with their lives, or they're not offered more. So I wish that when somebody sees me, they see me as like, you know what, she was able to do it. I'm also able to do it.
Fantastic. But the one thing also about where you come from is there's so much talent from Eastern Cape and Queenstown. Some of my favorite musicians I've realized are all from the same area.
Yeah.
But your brand new single is titled Angelina. We're going to speak about that on the other side of this. But if you have any questions for Oleti, you're more than welcome to call me right now. The number is 089-110-3377. It's 1124.